Hello and welcome. We're coming to you from Kempinski and we are right here for the official launch of Obis Ventures. And of course, with us today is the Queen of the East, Nadia Mukami. How are you doing?
I'm great. Yeah. I feel great. Uh-huh. Yes.
You're looking good.
Thank you. Uh-huh. Queen things.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes. Obis Ventures. Yeah. Of course, here to deal with events majorly. Yeah. What do you love the most about events?
I think it's getting paid to perform, mm-hmm. of course, uh-huh. But just being on stage, mm-hmm. with my fans, mm-hmm. sharing my music to them, performing, mm-hmm. when they can finally see me doing my thing on stage. Uh-huh. So yeah, that's I think one of the best things. Uh-huh. Yeah,
getting the money.
Uh-huh. Money. You obviously have hosted your own events. Yeah. Have you ever had any event flop?
Yeah, hiyo ni kawaida ukiwa kwenye muziki. Sometimes you have people, but especially the first events, watu wamejaa, lakini ni kama uli overspend on certain things. Mm-hmm. So you find that the profits hazilingani kabisa. Mm-hmm. So you just do it, you're like, next time maybe it will be better. Mm-hmm. I think events is yuko na character sana.
Maybe Nadia, talking about an event flopping, when was this, your event flopping?
Nikiwa campus, uh-huh. number one. The first love and vibes. Ilija ilikuwa Meru. Mm-hmm. But kabla utoe pesa ya sound yote, ulipe wasanii, mm-hmm. accommodation, mm-hmm. mafuta za kutoka Nairobi hadi huko, mm-hmm. food. Yani, there are always hidden charges. Yeah. That's when you're like, bruh, your profits are not that much. Uh-huh. Yeah.
And maybe to someone planning, mm-hmm. to do an event, of course people are out there planning to do events and things like, yeah. that. What is that one advice that you'll give to them?
I think it's number one, mm-hmm. I'll talk about the industry that I'm in. Yeah. Make sure that you may indulge Kenyan artists. We have a scenario whereby, and you know, what is a habit, baadaye ukua, yani ni mazoeo every single day. So for me, it's let's create ile culture ya artists headlining, ni Kenyan artists. Make sure there is gender balance. Come there, 5 male artists, let there be like 5 female artists, and just pay artists well. It's very expensive to be an artist. You understand, especially a female artist. Looking this good, he wig ni around 15,000, 15,000-16,000, imagine. So styling it is around 2,000, 2,500. Depends, 1,500 to 2,500. Makeup 25 to 3,000. Imagine, haya, nguo poa, imagine, tseme ka 5K, apo 6K. Depends, sometimes unaweza vaya pesa. Ujengea kwa viatu, ujengea kwa kucha, accessories. So people shouldn't feel like you're doing a favor. You understand? So I feel like they need to pay artists well. Because we spend on audios, videos, just pay them well. It marketing is so damn expensive, so people just need to pay artists well. Yeah.
Talking about the industry, about a week ago you released your newest, biggest, the best album, Queen of the East. So far, so good, Nadia.
Yeah. So right now we've surpassed over a million views, a million streams on Boomplay. We are almost a million streams on Spotify, almost a million streams on YouTube, and even platforms in this account, I'm counting like the major ones. So that means that we're doing great. So the album in just a week, today marks 1 week. So I really feel so blessed. That's why I'm so happy. Others in the corner frowned, your album, I find power, but in a fanya power, so I'm so happy. So yeah, thank you guys for supporting your girl. You know, keep supporting, more hits coming up.
Kabisa, kabisa. And what would you say goes into writing? Because your music does really well.
Thank you.
What do you say goes into writing? Like good music.
Yeah. It's number one, you have to be really mentally stable. Like, because ni job, nini akili zetu ndi ofisi zetu. So that's why usijichanganye kama msanii usingie kwa madawa sijui nini kwa sababu your mind is your office, so you must be mentally okay for you to get good music. Number two is motivation. You must be motivated, like ukiamka like uko kwa hiyo zone, uko kwa zone flani. And that's why you find that sometimes hata msanii amenyamaza ni kwa sababu ya creativity block. It happens to me. Naweza nyamaza hata 3 months. Kwa sababu siko motivated, I'm going through creativity block, which is writing. Hata watu wanaweza sema, okay, basi tuchukue songwriter. Even delivering needs like your mind, ujue venye uteka melodies. Yeah. So it's a lot. You have to be okay upstairs. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Talking about motivation, what's your greatest motivation, especially in doing music?
My son, right now, because he's now my everything. I mean, once you get a child, you're always scared, but once you have a child, the thought of just seeing that boy smile, he has a very personality. So he's always laughing. Hi, mama. He's always just saying such things. So I feel so blessed when I see that boy smile, that boy. He has such a cute personality. So he just makes me niamke kila siku nifanye mambo yangu.
Talking about your son, I think from comments you've seen online once in a while, not even once in a while, most of the time, you have a very supportive partner also. Maybe you can talk about that.
I think Ali, or rather our boy, he's such a good dad. One of the things that I did correct was choosing a good father for my child. Yeah. That one I ticked, you know, because I've mentioned it so many times in interviews, the number of times I'm like, should I go here for this tour, leaving my son behind? He's like, waenda. Ni kuna mtu tu around. Ata sometimes kama hayuko around. But just someone to kukuambia, you can do this, is just enough. Especially when you're leaving your child. Yo, ni ngumu. But him just, yani, akuna siku mtoto wangu na feel like amenisahau, like nikama siko, no. Anakuwa supportive, like, but once I get that time ya kuspend na mtoi, sasa ni time yetu. Kama sayi anaenda shule, I make sure that mimi ndio nimeamka na mtayarisha asubuhi, na make sure ameingia kwa school van, and it's so beautiful. So he's really been instrumental in just picking up, like, after being a mother, after having Kai, yeah.
And just speaking of social media, and just seeing what is happening, you being there, by necessity, by the way, have you ever been body shamed?
So many times. The time I had my baby, oh, me gain weight. Kuna times when I'm ovulating, na furanga, na blood tumbo sana. So sometimes mtu anaona, Nadia unapata mtoto mwingine, but in real case, huwezi anza kuexplain kwa kila mtu, I'm ovulating. So me, when I ovulate, I blot. Yanu nezadhani, kitambi yangu ni kama, I really blot. So najuanga, and sometimes you must make appearances. Sometimes blotting inaizanza tu, kama ushava outfit kwa event utadu. So I think people should really cut women some slack. Our bodies go through a lot. Kuna times na cramp. Hadi, ukiona mood yangu, unaweza sema maybe niko na mood swings, ama mimi seem poor, but my cramps, nasikia nikaa naweza anguka. Like sometimes I even take a day off. I can even cancel something because I'm in so much pain. So yeah, people have called me, oh, fat, jinini. This body little mtoi, imagine. So mimi nianze kukaa hapo, nianze kubishana naye. That's why I picked up where I left once I had my baby and kept going like nikama sija have mtoi. So mkaongea mnaongea hainihusu. Me, I know what like the things are, after CS, tena, it's hard to even lose like 40 like that. It's hard to even go to the gym like that. Yeah, you understand. So for me, it was like, me najipenda.
Talking about that, you know, Juicy too, we have seen what happened. And there was uproar online because one bishop talked something about Pretty Visual, though they sold it. But now the fact remains, tuambia nini tu kweli, hiyo kitu haijatoka kwa akili yetu. We all know what he said. What would you tell people out there?
I have an opinion, but it will be perceived the wrong way. So let me just keep that opinion to myself. But we shall solve imeisha.
What would you tell maybe Pretty Visha at this point?
She's I don't want to discuss this story because I avoid issues like that. Size, mwili, sijui amesema. So it's like, kama mmesemeana, imetosha. Yeah, kwa yule mwingine, usitusi mwenzako, hakuna mtu amejiumba, hakuna mtu aliandikia Mwenyezi Mungu barua, kamwambia, naomba unilete, sisi wote tulijipata hapa. Mimi ni mfupi, watu wameniita, mimi ni mfupi sana. Lakini, my personality is up there. I don't let anyone dim my light. I've done big things for myself. So don't let anyone tell you yourself. Like, get your confidence on. There is a book I was reading and they said the best cloth you can wear is confidence. Yeah.
And by the way, how does Arrow support you through, you know, those cramps, those everything that you go on body-wise, and even after having your baby?
At first, you never used to get it. Because haelewi, like mtu anaweza dhani unajifanya. But cramps, especially after having my baby, it's like, because there's a time I had like mini cysts, just naitwa aje. There's a time I was going through medication. Hazikuwa serious sana. But I think after umepata tu mtoi, sijui vitu tuzi utokea tu, vitu hata uko unajua. So I really cramp, I have a serious back pain. But he's, you know, sometimes ataniambia pole, ataniletea chakula kama nimelala the whole day. Yes, slowly by slowly amekuwa akiget it.
Yeah. Nadia, pengine we tuende turudi nyuma kidogo kwenye album. I really love to know. Ni ngoma gani ambayo haukutarajia perform vizuri lakini unaona sasa hivi it's picking up really well.
Kipepeo. Actually the song ambayo I thought and everybody from my 1RPM team to my guys, everyone thought the song with the Bye Bye song with Fina and Wendy Shea was gonna be like, but to their surprise, the song that is leading in terms of streams, ni Kipepeo, ndo ina lead actually for all the songs. Yeah.
Tukiangalia pia, I think upande wa Tanzania, I think there's the contemporary tumekuwa tukiona wasanii wapya wa kike ambao wanachipuka sana and they are doing really well. Na here in Kenya pia tunawaona but not as much as TZ. Do you think Kenya bado kuna potential ya kupata wasanii wapya wa kike ambao wanaweza kufanya vizuri?
Yes, I think wasanii wanachipukia. It's just that our industry is very toxic. So lazima yani ukwetu mvumilivu. So to any female artist, may know someone who's quit, you know, music recently. And I feel like our industry, yani, you cry in the job, but she's scared, like, yeah. Sometimes itu ni ngumu, mi nalia, najipanguza machozi, naendelea kusmile, naendelea kumove on. So I feel like our industry is very toxic, so you really have to get some barrier, your shock barrier, na ukwe too patient. Nimeambiwa no, hadi hizo no, sahi. Mtu akiniambia no. Siezi ata, niko tu okay, thank you, I'll try next time. So kitambo no, unalia. So just keep going. Our industry is very toxic and once you realize that, unaweka tu barriers, unasema tu, I'm going to keep on trying. Kama this is what I love, this is what I want to do, just keep on trying. I mean, unaweza andika proposals, ukona event, remember, okay, it's very positive. Weka ata, tunaifanya. Event imefika, ukona sponsor, moja na si major sponsor. Ama you have a music video, haujamaliza, like budgets has your line. You understand? Like, so keep on fighting. Yeah.
Pengine pia niulize, I think a few years back when we saw Gengeton come in, we saw big artists wakitokea na kusupport our wasanii, but on urban tone hatujaona kwa sana. Sijui wewe mwenyewe ni ngoma una ni type of music unaiamini, ni type of music pengine
you look sana TikTok anapenda TikTok. Yeah, like I think one of sijui ya Diana Codes si hiyo ngoma ni kali. Like, I think nimekuwa fan especially wa dem kama Diana Codes for a long time akimba some R&B, you understand? Like I think wakadinali ndo wamempush sana kwa game, like sai after the collab with AJ anafanya poa. So I think behind the scenes napenda, and I think kila mtu tu akona audience yake, whatever works for you. I would never say ati mziki flani sijui. If you don't like it, just that it does not appeal to you. I always say never say you don't like a certain type of music. Just say I'm not the target audience. Yeah. So for me, being an artist, I have to listen to everything. I have to see what's popping and support my sisters. If she wants my support, if you wanna launch album, I can launch, call me.
kuna story moja ya blogs eh ambapo Arrowboy aliwahi kusema kwamba kama itambidi kuoa mke mwingine ndo apate watoto wengine itabidi afike hapo. Wewe sijui unichukuliaje hiyo.
Number 1, haizipata kama mimi. So hata kijaribu atakuwa ame
atarudi tu.
Atakuwa ame downgrade. Ame look at me. Atatoa pick kama mimi. You understand, like I'm a full package baby. So it's gonna be a magic chata. Watu watani grill anyway, but nikupua kujiamini. I think haizi tupata kama mimi. Anaza jaribu, but...
You okay just, with him trying?
He can't. Haizi pata kama mimi. Haizi.
You could try?
Hawezi. Jua kilo time to be, of course, I'll just leave. You know, me I'm... Like, kama mtu anitaki me, I'll just walk away. That's... I'm so good, like... I'm so good at that. But, so, like, haizi pata. Kama mimi.
Tumeona juzi kumekuwa na miongoni mwa post ambayo ili trend sana ilikuwa ni ya Flaco baada ya kuandika kwamba mwaka ni kama wa breakup sana. Wewe sijui una maoni yapi kuhusu breakups ambazo zinaendelea sasa?
Nasema just let's give couples grace. You understand? I feel like kwa sababu tu uko kwa limelight na uko in a relationship haimaanishi that it's perfect. Like mudu unasema it's the same thing. Hata wewe kila mtu kuna time kina kurambo unakaa unajua is this the right person. But relationships are like that. Na mimi nasemaga hakuna mtu perfect. Mimi mwenyewe hata in my own relationship I'm not perfect. My partner is not perfect, so you just need to give each other grace. Unless it's violent or there is cheating or to like so kwani chafu. But let's just give each other grace to pay what to time and to work through or just get through stuff and just pray against the spirit of separation, divorce, and if it happens we just pray for them, they do it cordially. Because just because you're famous haimaanishi ati relationship yako itakuwa perfect. Kama tu watu wa kawaida wana break up every single day. So it's let's just give them grace. Yeah.
A final question from me. Yeah. Talking about maybe couples who have had their life on social media, what is that one? Because we have had this debate online. Oh, mambo na mapenzi, watoto, familia, usieke kwenye mitandao, vitu kama hizo. What is that one advice you'll give couples who have their life out there on social media?
Just like I said previously, let's give couples grace. Like, for as much as kila mtu, unajua watu wako tofauti. Kuna watu wenye hiyo ndo mboka yao, hiyo ndo type of hustle yao. So tusiwa tusema ati mtu afai kufanya. Mimi si gatekeeper. You do whatever works for you. But kama kuna kitu yenye involve mtoto, just know how to work around it. Na, you know, every, kila siku, take one day at a time. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Nadia.
Thank you. Nimeongea sana. Wapi maji?